But then you turn and walk away.
Just when you thought you knew the rules, the game changes. We must change with it. I see you on the streets,
and you just pass me by. Well, GameChanger is really looking at, this is a new time. You know, we're living in the age of Obama, the time where things have happened in this country that we thought we'd never see happen. We have a black attorney general, we have a black president, a commander in chief, leader of the free world is a black man. And I really feel like it's time for young black men, old black men, middle-aged black men to realize that, you know, it's all or nothing. You know, it's like the fourth quarter, last down. You know, no time left on the clock, and it's time to just get out there and lift our game to the highest level possible. And so the game changer, this whole concept is around focusing on what our assets are, not our deficits, focusing on what we do right, what makes us unique, you know, what makes us the strongest, most powerful, most envied people in the world.
Being a game changer means sometimes making mistakes, but making sure you learn from those mistakes. Being a game changer does mean that you necessarily are committed to some ideals. Doesn't mean that you have to have the most lofty ideals. It could just mean you want to finish high school. You want to be the first in your family to go to college. You want to be the first in your family to complete college. You want to be the first in your family to have a professional job, to be a doctor, a lawyer, an astronaut, judge. Whatever vision you have of how you want to change your own reality, changing the reality around you starts with you. You must first take action to improve and change your own reality for the better, and then you can begin to change the reality in circles around you.
Well, I think the two most important things to be game changers, one is that we have to be ready to claim our sense of individual power, our sense of individual leadership, to change the games, in our own lives, in our own families, in our own communities. I think the second thing that we have to do to be game changers is we gotta be willing to organize others. We've gotta build a broader sense of power, we gotta build a broader sense of vision, and a broader sense of people that are engaged in trying to change those negative forces outside of us. And so, if we can do those things, then I think things will begin to fall into place, and I think indeed the game will be changed.
Here we are in Oakland, California, one of the most beautiful cities in America. But for some, that beauty ends right here. In fact, it was on these steps more than a generation ago. The Black Panthers marched and protested against the unfair treatment of their community. Well now, the 2025 campaign for black men and boys has launched a national effort to improve the outcomes of black males in America. The campaign asks one central question. What can we do to improve the life of a black boy born in 2007 so that by the time he's 18, his life has significantly improved across five areas? Those areas? Health, education, fatherhood, employment, and justice.
The 2025 campaign is an important resource for us tackling the tough issues that are really impacting the lives of black men and boys in their communities. It's a place where advocates, practitioners, researchers, policymakers, other stakeholders can come and find information about what works to improve education outcomes, employment outcomes, health outcomes for Black men and boys. The 2025 campaign site provides that connective tissue. It's one way in which we keep people in this field connected and informed about each other's efforts.
So the 2025 campaign was started out of our listening sessions when we initiated our Black Men and Boys Initiative. I should say that the 21st Century Foundation is a national foundation committed to investing in and supporting Black community change. And really, as a part of that, we were listening to organizations in different cities that we had identified in New York, Chicago, Oakland, Los Angeles. And one of the themes that came out in all the conversations in the different cities were, they would say, well, you know what, Kevin Powell was just here just a few weeks ago with the State of Black Men Tour, and the National Urban League was just here, and Barbara Lee and Danny Davis had just done a number of conversations related to Black men and boys. And so are you as national organizations talking together? And the answer was no. And so we had a conversation with the National Urban League, with Public-Private Ventures, with the NAACP Legal Defense Fund, and we asked, could we convene a national conversation to explore ways that we could, as national groups, start to talk about Black men and boys and see if there were some commonalities. And really, after a series of conversations, we started the 2025 campaign.
So how do Black men and boys become the change to change the game? Good question. That's the question of the campaign. That's what we're focused on. One of the things that our campaign is focused on is assets. We know the problems, we know the negative statistics, but we're focused on telling the positive stories and sharing those with the world. Like this brother right here. He's out here hustling. What is he selling? Silence the Violence tapes. So he's an MC, he's a rapper, right? And instead of doing something negative, selling drugs, doing any other kind of legal activity, he's promoting change through selling his tapes. And promoting peace. You know, he's promoting change in the community. He's a game changer right there. So when people tell me that a lot of young people can't do this, that they'll think this is corny, that they're not down with change and trying to be positive, I don't agree, because I see it in my community every day. Black males in Oakland face the same obstacles that, you know, other black males face in every other city in America. So whether it be Chicago, New York, Detroit, you know, New Orleans, it's the same old song. Basically, you know, we are at risk and are marginalized in areas for opportunity, whether it be education, whether it be healthcare, whether it be employment. We've got to do something different.